So the topic of today is Office 365 federation with SafeNet Trusted Access, and more specifically using a PowerShell script to simplify the federation related tasks. So the first thing I need to do is to log into the SafeNet Trusted Access console. I do that by email, and then because my user has several different authenticators, I'm using a keyboard shortcut P to trigger push authentication to my mobile device. I there review the authentication request, make sure it's me, adding my finger as an additional factor, you know, something you are, something I am rather, and that takes me to the SafeNet Trusted Access administration console. From here, I want to make sure that I have an Office 365, their app, and there it is. And then I want to use the simplified configuration flow based on metadata configuration to accomplish the integration. So I'm clicking on metadata configuration, download metadata file, and you see that in the lower left corner. With that out of the way, I want to establish that at least some users will have access to this application, so I assign it, in my case, to all users, and that probably makes sense since Federation is a global setting and everybody wants email access. Following that, I want to make sure I have some sort of access control policy applied, and this one reads permit or grant access to all users for the app Office 365 if and only if the authentication method or strength is OTP or one-time password. What you might do for a POC, for instance, is you could require just password or the main password for the majority of the user population, and then require OTP or MFA for the POC participants. This could be made a lot more granular than that, so you could consider, for instance, user location, user device form factor, and things like you could consider risk, for example, the use of an anonymized connection or a location change. But we'll go with the bare minimum for now, pretty much, and at this point I'm fairly happy and content that this will work as far as a basic demo goes. So I log out and let's have a look at the script. So I'm showing this in Visual Studio Code, so it looks more complex than it is. You could run this from terminal, of course. The script will do a couple of things. Among others, it will examine if prerequisites are met, and if not, it will try to install them to meet them. It will then present a menu where you can perform federation. Having done that, or in whichever order you prefer, you can break a federation, meaning you can return a domain to managed mode. The script will also allow you to test authentication or test federation. So without further ado, let me show you this in action. Okay, let me make this a little bit larger for you. And here we go, the prerequisites are met and I am presented with that menu. So to kind of make certain where we are, to understand where we are, I go with option 3 to test the authentication. And that will launch the Office 365 or Microsoft Online login process. And at this point, I need to log in as an administrator. So username or rather email or UPN and password will then list the domains within that organization and their authentication mode. So managed. Okay, so no domain is federated. Next, let's have a look at federating a domain. So option 1 will do that. And again, I will need to log in as administrator in Office 365. Email address, fixed password, and the script will then show us the domains within my organization. I select the first one, which is my public domain. I will be asked to name the federation. I go with STOF or SafeNet Trusted Access. The script will then present a browse dialog where I can browse to the metadata file that was previously downloaded, and it actually filters on XML. Next, it will present a summary of the settings that I have applied and the parameters that were found in the metadata file. If I confirm, it will perform the federation. But of course, we want to make absolutely certain. So option 3 again, we'll test. And so far it looks all the same, right, doesn't it? So username, but then something happens. It redirects to the SafeNet Trusted Access IDP. I select login. And again, I use another method now, G for grid. And here I have to use a memorized pattern and then use the numericals currently representing that pattern. So this is great if you don't want to carry a hardware authenticator, you don't want to rely on your phone, you can use this method instead. Anyways, Sved demo is now federated. At the end of a trial, or if you want just an option to divest from this product, you can use option 2, return federated domain to manage mode. And as before, I will need to log in as administrator in Office 365. It will redirect me to the stall IDP, and I'm gonna do this a little bit faster now, G for grid, and then whatever numbers represent my pattern currently. And the script will filter on domains that are currently federated, so just one. And I'm gonna take that and confirm it. And according to the script, we're all done, but again, I want to make absolutely certain. So option 3 again should tell us that. One last time now, username or UPN or email. And already we know that this domain is no longer federated because we have a fixed password dialog box here. So my fixed password, sign in, and domains are managed, managed, and managed, and that takes us to the end of this.